Local anesthesia is used in many dental procedures and one that you must master in order to become an excellent dental provider. This video will overview key elements of dental local anesthesia that the provider needs to be aware of anytime they administer an injection. Specific injections will also be covered in separate videos. Prior to seeing your patient, you'll want to set up your operatory and armamentarium or instruments. Syringe setup is straightforward. Included in most dental cassettes is the metal standard anesthetic syringe. Holding it in your hand, you can see there is an area for your thumb to rest. The thumb rest allows you to aspirate and verify that you are not injecting into a blood vessel. Further down the syringe, there is a finger rest. Find the most comfortable position for you, as this may vary from operator to operator and from procedure to procedure. The barrel of the syringe will hold the anesthetic cartridge. Inside, you will see a piston and harpoon. The harpoon, which looks like an arrow or a hook, engages into the rubber stopper of the anesthetic cartridge. At the end of the syringe, there is an adapter that allows for needle attachment. We typically use a short blue 30-gauge needle or a long yellow 27-gauge needle in the dental school clinic. To set up the syringe, twist off the clear end of the needle, insert the needle into the syringe. Pull back the syringe and place an anesthetic cartridge into the barrel, rubber stopper side contacting the harpoon. Be careful not to bend the needle upon insertion of the cartridge. Give the syringe a firm tap to engage the rubber stopper. Prior to administering an injection, topical anesthesia should be used for patient comfort. Here, we'll use a 20% benzocaine gel that includes a cotton swab in the packaging. Topical works better on dry mucosa, so dry the injection site with gauze before placing topical for 1 minute. It is advised that you uncap and recap the needle by yourself in 2 steps to avoid accidental needle sticks. To uncap, loosen the cap of the needle, pull the needle away from the cap, and proceed with the anesthetic delivery. When using the syringe, it is important where you position yourself so as to ensure safety and avoid unnecessary patient anxiety and fear. In general, the needle should be out of the patient's line of sight and pointed away from you or any assistant you may have. Be aware of your surroundings, especially when you are working in a learning environment such as a dental school. You should retract with an instrument or mirror whenever possible. Generally speaking, you do not want a hand in close proximity to an uncapped needle intraorally. While this is not an absolute rule, be aware of your increased risk you put yourself in and avoid hand retraction whenever possible. At this stage, you may go ahead and provide the necessary anesthesia. As this varies by procedure, individual injections are covered in separate videos. To recap, position the cap towards you, remove your hand and insert the needle into the cap. Then use a mirror or your hand to tighten the cap onto the needle. Alternatively, there is a needle cap holder designed in many cassettes that you may use. If you need to exchange an anesthetic cartridge, pull back the syringe after twisting the thumb ring and ensure that the needle is no longer inserted in the cartridge. Push the cartridge from the back of the syringe and pop it through the window. Insert a new cartridge and proceed accordingly.